Praying Grace, the conviction of God's fatherhood. So you have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Instead, you received God's spirit when he adopted you as his own children. Now we call him Abba, Father, for his spirit joins with our spirit to affirm that we are God's children, and since we are his children, we are his heirs. How easy it is to fall into the trap of striving to earn your standing as a son or daughter of God, to constantly scratch and grope around for a fleeting feeling of acceptance or an elusive sense of worthiness based on your good behavior. Like the embittered brother of the prodigal son, we can work, sacrifice, and struggle in self-denial in a prideful quest to attain what is already fully ours. Or like the prodigal himself, we can come to God with the mindset of a servant, feeling unworthy, unclean, and disqualified. Neither son understood his true position or standing in the gracious heart of their father. In a similar way, we desperately need a revelation that God is indeed our Father, that he has set his love upon us, drawn us with cords of love, and irrevocably adopted us as his own. The 19th century hymn writer F.W. Faber once said, "There is all the difference in the world between searching for evidences of my sonship and receiving the conviction of God's fatherhood. The one is an endless, profitless, soul-tormenting task. The other is the light and liberty, the glorious liberty of the children of God." God chose to be your father. Believe it. Receive it. Pray like it. Dear Abba Father, flood my soul with a revelation of your fatherhood to me. Forgive me for striving to merit a place at your table. Help me rest confidently in the knowledge that I am your child, not by virtue of what I have or haven't done, but because I am in your Son Jesus and he is in me. Amen. Hosanna Shalom.